Today we'll learn how to build robots that move. We're going to control a servo motor using an Arduino microcontroller so that you can build robots like my moving Remy from Ratatouille or my working Venus flytrap that snaps shut when something is in his mouth. Let's get started. Arduino is a brand name for a microcontroller, which is like a small programmable computer. You'll need one of these boards, plus the free Arduino IDE software, which you can download at arduino.cc. Servos are great because you can move them to a relatively precise angle and you don't need an external battery. To connect the servo to the Arduino, we need three wires, one each for power, ground, and data. It doesn't matter what color wires you use, but it's helpful to use at least red and black to keep power and ground organized. Plug one of the wires into the slot connected to the red wire on the servo. This wire should connect to the 5V pin on the Arduino, which stands for 5 volts. Now we'll add a wire connecting the brown wire on the servo to the GND pin on the Arduino, which stands for ground. Finally, the orange or yellow wire should connect to almost any arbitrary numbered pin. The numbered pin you use does need to have a little squiggle next to it, which stands for PWM, aka pulse width modulation. That's a special capability that will help our servo motor move. We'll use pin number 3. Now let's open the Arduino IDE and write some simple code to control the servo's position. The IDE has some pre-populated code and we'll leave that there. When you code, capitalization matters, but spaces do not. Keep that in mind as we start coding. Above all the pre-filled code, we're going to include the servo library by typing hashtag include open caret servo.h closed caret. Make sure to capitalize the S in servo. Then we create a servo object by writing servo with a capital S, which tells the computer the object's type. Then we give our servo any name we want. I'm calling mine servo with a little s. Be sure to end the line with a semicolon. Then inside this setup function, we can erase the grayed out comment and then write code to attach the servo to the numbered pin we decided to use, in this case, 3. Finally, we move to the loop function, which the Arduino will run forever or until you disconnect power. We can erase the comment again, and now we're going to tell the servo to write an angle between 0 and 180 degrees. We'll start with 0. Then we're going to wait for 1000 milliseconds, which equals 1 second, to give the servo time to move. We'll do this by writing delay, open parentheses, 1000, end parentheses, semicolon. Next, we'll swing the servo to 180 degrees. And finally, we'll wait another second by using the delay 1000 one last time. Now we'll plug our Arduino into the computer and select the board, Arduino Uno, and the port that we're using. Click the check mark to compile the code. If you see a red error message after compiling, there's probably a typo in your code. Double check the code for capitalization and punctuation. Then click the arrow pointing to the right to upload your code to the Arduino. It'll take a minute to upload and then the motor should start to move back and forth. Here's a full screen view of what the final code should look like. Now you can edit the numbers to move to whatever angle you want between 0 and 180. You can also control a servo motor using external input, like from, say, a light sensor. If that's something you're interested in, let me know what type of sensor you want to see and I'll make a tutorial. Servos have some downsides. The plastic ones are not very strong. Mine was barely strong enough to fold foam in half for my Venus flytrap hat. But you can get more expensive metal ones that are stronger. They're kind of loud too, so if you use a lot of them, it can get noisy. But overall, they're pretty inexpensive and really easy to use, so I hope this video was helpful. Let me know what you want to see next.